Washington, D.C.'s Anacostia and Potomac Rivers, as well as lesser-known Rock Creek and Oxen Run, are rich with history dating back to the times of the Native Americans and John Smith. In recent years, D.C.'s rivers have been plagued with sewage and trash caused by stormwater pollution. In 2007, the District Department of the Environment launched the RiverSmart Homes program as a way to combat the city's serious stormwater problem. Private property is the single largest land use in the nation's capital, and the program actively engages the community in restoring the rivers. Thanks to this unique Urban Waters partnership, homeowners from all of the city's wards are enthusiastically adopting environmentally friendly landscaping practices to help save these historic rivers.
Before we started this program, we had had similar programs, and what we found is that residents don't understand these technologies necessarily. They don't know how to plant a tree correctly. They are afraid of cutting their downspouts. Also, about 50% of the district residents don't own cars. So if you offer a rain barrel at a recreation center, they have no way of getting it home.
RiverSmart focuses on five green practices that can be easily installed on residential lots throughout the city: rain barrels, rain gardens, native plant landscaping, tree planting, and pervious pavers. Demonstration homes in each of the city's eight wards feature all five practices. Kathy St. Hill owns the demonstration home in Ward 7.
I actually found out about the RiverSmart Homes program from the DC Department of the Environment's website. I decided to participate in the RiverSmart Homes program because I wanted to do some landscaping on my property and realized that I could incorporate some environmental practices as well.
We have trees that we were able to plant. They have a large backyard with a lot of room for trees. They also had a downspout where we had a good flat area to install a rain garden and a rain barrel. And they also had an area that was once a large cement patio, and we were able to remove that and replace it with native landscaping.
Sit, drop it.
Good girl.
I come home now, and if I've had a rough day, I can go out there and work in the yard, and I love it. I absolutely love it.
In 2008, the RiverSmart Homes program expanded beyond the demonstration homes to a pilot program in the Pope Branch watershed, a tributary which feeds into the Anacostia River.
Well, we started in Pope Branch because it's a clearly defined area. Additionally, there's a high amount of home ownership. There were a lot of retired and African-American homeowners in this area, and those were target audiences that we wanted to learn what techniques worked in reaching out to them. And so that's why we chose this area.
The pilot program assisted homeowners through the entire process of selecting, installing, and maintaining green practices on their property. After the homeowner registers for the program, the first step is a stormwater audit.
We schedule an audit where we go out to visit the homeowner, look at what can be safely installed, and we provide the homeowner with a stormwater audit that gives them the background information to understand what are the problems on their property, what sort of actions can they take that beautify their property, but also reduce stormwater on their property.
We see it as an opportunity to really interact with DC homeowners and let them know about the issues. And then if they decide to take a further step and actually install something, we think that's an added bonus to the whole process.
The homeowner selects which of the recommended practices they wish to have installed, and then signs an agreement that includes a commitment and information on how to maintain the practices. After the agreement is signed, the District Department of the Environment's nonprofit partners install the practices. Funding is available to each property owner to help cover material and installation costs, which generally covers native tree plantings, downspout disconnection to a rain barrel, and one other technique. Homeowners pay a co-payment that is approximately 10% of the total cost.
One of the things that we learned, for example, was that having a co-payment was important to the people here because they felt that it would give them ownership of the different things that we were installing. We didn't want to just give it to them for free, then they wouldn't think of it really as something that was important for them to maintain.
Prior to participating in the RiverSmart Homes program, Jennifer and Dion Black were struggling with a quantity of stormwater and mosquitoes in their backyard.
So whenever we got even a light rain, but particularly in really heavy rain, you know, we'd have standing water there for days after a rain. All that standing water seems to be a mosquito breeding ground. You'd stand outside with shorts on, you look on your leg, there'd be like 10 sitting on each leg. So
it's pretty bad. We have two small children, boys. They're 2 and 4. And they love to play in the yard, and sometimes it was just too wet to let them play.
And with the mosquitoes, you just didn't want the mosquitoes all over them either. But since we've had this work done, it's been much, much better.
The homeowners here had an issue with the topography of their property. This area actually here was naturally very wet. You can see that the property slopes down this way, and it slopes from over here and over here. So it's creating this natural valley. And so we created this rain river type garden that instead of the water sitting here, it moves along this stone. And by the time it reaches the back of their yard, most of it has infiltrated into the ground. This creates a focal point for their backyard. It's usable. It actually draws water away from some of the areas that maybe would be wet. So this is a great kind of addition to their yard.
Our next door neighbors are new, and she actually asked us, what is going on over there? And we told her all about the program, and I know she called and is very interested in actually possibly continuing the rain garden in her yard. And I know some of our other neighbors down the street have also participated.
Well, one of the things we want to do with our stormwater management is to try and keep, you know, reduce the amount of water that makes its way to the Anacostia River. So we're trying to keep, you know, maintain the natural flow of water, keep it on the property as it would be, and keep that balance in the Anacostia River. It's a great river and we have to protect it.
Up the street from the Black family, Donald and Barbara Harrison were also struggling with stormwater runoff in their backyard.
So at this property, there's a lot of water coming towards the backyard. You can see the driveway slopes all the way down. This whole area slopes down and kind of converges right behind me in this rain garden. So all of this is just natural flow that's just flowing down the property to this area. And you can see that there's neighbors behind. So we also wanted to try to stop some of the runoff from reaching the neighbor's backyard. So that's why we placed the rain garden right here. It captures all the runoff from the driveway and then anything that's just running down here.
The rain garden has prevented the water from rolling down the hill, causing the erosion or the faster erosion of the hill. So we're pretty fortunate to have that there.
The steep slopes and the resulting stormwater runoff that were a challenge for the Black and Harrison families are a common problem for other residents of the Pope Branch watershed.
If you look at this slope, it's a very steep slope, and there's a lot of houses here, all with their own individual footprint of impervious surface. And all that impervious surface adds up to a lot of stormwater that's coming down to our local streams. So if we can get each homeowner to adopt practices like this, it'll slow down that flow, that giant flow that's currently there, to a trickle of stormwater that's coming to this area.
Neighbors of the Harrison and Black families, Calvin and Celestine Sneed, live on a very steep slope. When they were in the market to replace their driveway, they learned of the RiverSmart Homes program.
When it came around, they explained what it was all about and the fact that we could get the pavers and DDOE would pay a certain amount of it, which that was outstanding. Well, we needed a new driveway, so that was a good thing.
We took from the carport down to the street to install the permeable paving. It's taking water from the hillside that flows to the retaining wall and then out the weep holes. And it's also taking any of the rainwater that would have fallen on the driveway itself. All that in a regular rainstorm would have rushed off of the site, down these gutters and out into the Anacostia or into Pope Branch and then into the Anacostia River. Now it slowly percolates into the ground. Some of it is released over time, but for the most part, the water is going into the ground and recharging the groundwater.
It's the prettiest driveway on this street, at least.
We think so.
It was a no-brainer, yeah.
Today, the River Smart Homes program is open to all district residents, and the response has been overwhelming. More than 1,800 homeowners have applied for the program.
We thought this program might only appeal to certain residents or certain parts of DC, but we really have participation in every single ward in the city. And really from all different kinds of socioeconomic backgrounds, different ethnic backgrounds, it really goes across the board. And our program is really spread through word of mouth. Homeowners are really appreciative for an opportunity to not only beautify their landscape, but after we meet with them, they really understand the environmental impact, and I think they're very happy to be contributing to helping green their city.
Many urban waters across the country are polluted by stormwater, and communities are struggling to find cost-effective solutions. RiverSmart homeowners are enthusiastically installing green practices that help reduce and treat stormwater runoff, potentially saving the city the cost of new stormwater infrastructure. For DC and potentially other urban areas, this innovative program holds the promise of creating a greener, healthier, more climate-friendly city.